A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by...
Well done. You have completed the basic part of the Writer and Impress course modules. Now, you will learn about a new part of OpenOffice, which is called Spreadsheet or Calc. Before beginning this class, we would like to share that this is very important part of the Open Office. You all have to learn it very carefully. You can make a list, create results, and you can store huge amount of your data, and you can do all kind of calculations with the help of Spreadsheet or Calc. Mostly, Spreadsheet is used in schools, offices, etc. If you learn Spreadsheet well, you can get a job quite easily. Let us now learn about a new part of OpenOffice. Do you know what is a spreadsheet in OpenOffice? Spreadsheet is a part of the OpenOffice which is also called Calc. This Calc or spreadsheet functions like the Excel of MS Office. Spreadsheet is like a paper sheet which helps you store your data in the form of rows and columns. Spreadsheet makes your work simpler because it has many formulas about which you will learn later. This is also known by the name of tabular form. Now, all of you switch on your computers. Let us now know how we open the OpenOffice spreadsheet file. The spreadsheet file also can be opened in many ways. You can open it by the stepwise method or by using the icon on the desktop or by using the shortcut command. The method to open is the same for Windows XP and Windows 7. However, in both Windows 8 and Windows 10, the stepwise method differs. The desktop shortcut method of opening is the same for all the versions of Windows. You will now be taught the method to open spreadsheet in Windows XP and Windows 7. For Windows 8 and Windows 10, you can watch the video and learn. Let us now watch this video and learn to open the spreadsheet in Windows XP and Windows 7. We will now learn the stepwise method of opening the spreadsheet or the Calc file. So to do this, bring your pointer to the start button on the left bottom of your screen. Click on that and then look for the All Programs option and left click on the All Programs option. As soon as you click, another box appears where there are many programs written. Now you have to scroll up and down and find the OpenOffice program. So when we scroll down, as is being shown in the video, we can see OpenOffice 4.1 option available. So when you take the pointer there and click there, you can see the various options of OpenOffice opening. So OpenOffice spreadsheet is also called OpenOffice Calc. So click on that option with the left button. And when you click, your spreadsheet becomes available to you or it opens. So this is the stepwise method to open the spreadsheet or the Calc file. Have you all been able to open the spreadsheet file or not? If not, then watch the video again and learn to open the spreadsheet file. Let us now learn more about spreadsheet. Look at the picture being shown to you. Can you tell what this picture in the box is called? As you have learned in Writer and Impress, this is called the title bar, which shows the name of your file and the software you are using. Can you tell what is the standard toolbar? And can you also tell which is the standard toolbar in the picture being shown to you? The standard toolbar is a shortcut way to help us do our work, since it has options of all the menus we use. Can you tell what is formatting toolbar and why do we use it? Formatting toolbar is also a kind of shortcut method that helps us in doing all types of formatting in a text. It has all the options for text formatting and makes it easy for you to use them. Look at the picture shown in front of you in the form of a box. Can you tell what is this called? This is called the formula bar, and it helps you to make changes in any formula and use the same. You will learn more about these formulas later. Look at this picture being shown to you, which shows two boxes. What are these called? These are called the column and row headers. Columns in a spreadsheet are always shown by alphabets, and this is called the column header. The rows are always shown by numbering, and these are called row headers. And both together are called column and row headers. Do you know how many sheets are already there in a spreadsheet window? Spreadsheet window has three sheets by default. In the given picture, you're being shown something like a box. Can you tell what is this called? This is called the status bar. In spreadsheet, the status bar tells you about the sheets, like how many sheets you have, and it also shows you about some of the formulas. It also shows the zoom box. Can you tell why we use the sidebar? As you already know, the sidebar also offers you a shortcut way to do your work. Whenever you type, it shows all the options for text, and when you work with pictures, then it shows all the formatting options for pictures. Besides these, there are other shortcut options also available in the sidebar. Let us now learn how and when we will use the spreadsheet arrow keys. Can you tell what is a cell? Cell is like a box. While using spreadsheet, wherever a black box appears, and then when you type there, it gets typed in that cell. Let us learn with the help of this video as to how do we use cells. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use each cell. So, for each cell, you can see that a black outline appears around the cell which has been selected. If you select any other cell by bringing the pointer there and click on that, that particular cell gets selected and the black boundary appears on this cell. Similarly, you can click here and this cell gets selected as is being shown in the video. Now if we want to work in the cell or to type something in the cell, we can start typing using our keyboard. So for instance, right now we have typed the word computer, and if we now take the pointer to some other cell and click there, you will find that the word that we had typed in this cell will remain there, and the other cell where we click with the pointer gets selected. So if you want, you can start typing in the second cell that you have selected. If you want to type something else in the same cell, go back there where you had written computer and select it once again by clicking. Now, if you want to type something else, then you will see that the first word that we had typed disappears and the new word which we have typed, like Shiksha we have typed, appears there. If you want to add something to the cell where already you have written something, then you can bring your pointer to the formula bar which is up here and then click on that. And since we are clicking in the beginning of the word Shiksha, we are now typing computer. So we have now typed computer and Shiksha is already there. So you will see that in that cell computer Shiksha gets written. Again, if you want to make some changes, you can click on the cell again to select it, and then you can click within the cell itself so that you will see the cursor blinking inside it. Now, if you want to remove the word Shiksha, just use the arrow keys to bring the cursor to the end of the word Shiksha, and then use backspace to clear the word Shiksha, and only computer remains. Now, if you take the pointer to another cell and click there to select that cell, you will find that the word computer is written in the cell that you were using. So this is how you can use various cells and you can type text within the cells. Can you tell what are rows? A row is made of many cells placed horizontally. To move from one cell in a row to the next, you can use the enter button. Let us now watch the video and learn how rows are used. With the help of this video, we are now going to learn how we use the rows. As you can see in your spreadsheet, on the left side, there are numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. There are many numbers. These are all the rows. So, if you look at the first row, like we are using the arrow key, the right arrow key, to move from one column to the next column in the first row, this is how you can go from one side to the next. So, these are all rows. And you can work in any of these rows by selecting. So we have now first selected the A1 cell, A column, and the first row. And we have typed name. So we are now using titles, and so that down below we can type the names. We select the B1 cell or the B column and the first row and write roll number in it. And to move from one cell to the next cell in the same row, we are using the right arrow key. So in the C1 cell, we have typed subject, and in D1, we have typed total. So this is how you can use the arrow keys to move. If you want to go down, you will use the down arrow key. If you want to go left, you will use the left arrow key. And again, if you want to go right, you will be using the right arrow key. And to go up, you'll be using the up arrow key. So you can move around in your spreadsheet by using the arrow keys. And now we can also select by just keeping our mouse or touchpad, the left button pressed, and then dragging it, you can select some cells and rows that you want. Similarly, you can select it also by using the arrow keys, by using the shift and the arrow keys. Like you're going right by pressing the shift and the right arrow key and it is getting selected. Keep the shift key pressed and press the down arrow key so more cells and more area of the spreadsheet get selected. You move towards the left with the left arrow key, the portion that you leave gets unselected. So this is how you can use the rows in the spreadsheet and also select the same. Can you tell what are columns? Columns are also made of many cells arranged vertically. Watch the video to learn more about using columns. With the help of this video, let us now learn how we use the various columns. The columns are denoted by alphabets. So A, B, C, D, E that you see on top of your table are all the column names. So right now we can see that in our columns, if you click on A, the A column gets selected. So in these columns, we have already written name, roll number, subject, total. So now we are selecting B and we can move up or down. We can go to the right side by using the right arrow keys. For going down, we use the down arrow key as is being shown in the video. Going down, we use the down arrow key and we can use the column. We can type anything that we like in this column, whether text or numbers. Now, if you want to select a column, you can click on the first cell with the left button of your mouse or touchpad and keep the button pressed and drag downwards. So the column will get selected as is being shown in the video. Similarly, we are selecting the column B. Then we are selecting the column C here by clicking on top and then keeping the button pressed, we drag it downwards. And while keeping the button pressed, if you drag towards the right side, more columns on the right side will get selected. If you drag towards the left side, more columns on the left side will get selected. So this way you can select the columns and you can work in these columns as is being shown in the video to you. In the next video, we will learn how we move from one sheet to the other. Let us also now see how we can go from one sheet to the other in our spreadsheet. As you know, by default, in spreadsheet, there are three sheets. And you can see here sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Right now, where name, roll number, subject, total is written is the sheet 1. So that has been the sheet number 1 is being selected. If you click on sheet 2 with your pointer, sheet 2 will open. If you click on sheet 3, sheet 3 will open. So this way you can come back and click on sheet 1 if you want to come back to sheet 1 and work on sheet 1 like this. So this way you can move around in the various sheets of the spreadsheet. Now all of you make a table in your spreadsheet like the one shown in the picture. If you face a problem in making the table, get help from your teacher. We will end today's class here. All of you, close your Calc files. You can close the Calc file in the same way that you close the writer or impress files. Next, properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned what is a spreadsheet and why we use it. Then you also learned about what is a title bar, what is standard toolbar, what is a formatting toolbar. You also learned about what are the column and row headers, what is a cell, what are rows, what are columns, and then you also made a table.
Computer Shiksha is supported by
Thank you.